Welcome back to Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past. Last time, we went and got ourselves a third magic bottle, beat off the second dungeon. And now we're going to be heading back to... Well, wait, we're going to be heading around back to Sanctuary. Because up there is something important. After the fact, we go to... I need to go to a place... around here. We can't get that piece apart yet, since on the floating island. Not a floating island, it's on an island in the middle of the lake, so we can't reach that yet. We're gonna go to Sanctuary in just a bit. I just want to get one thing back where we got the ice rod, so we're gonna go there really quick-like. Thanks to the might of that is the Pegasus Boots. And more 16-bit slowdown. Gotta love the Super Nintendo. Had some of the best games, but still had a bit of problems, and I didn't even get my hurt. No. You will not catch me for breakfast. I need something that'll kill you outright. Magic. Thank you. Wow, that was all my magic. I killed a thing by making it explode. I exploded, dude. I feel accomplished. Now I need to go up this way. However, I don't want to get hit by the frickin' crabs. I still have a fairy! Yeah! frickin' A, man. You need to die. Now I need to go in here and get myself some new fairies, because I need to enslave more fairies. You call it a fairy! I'm gonna keep them both in bottles, because I need more bottles. Well, I have 3 bottles now. There's only one more that I get at this. I forget where I get it, though. Crap. Someone's gonna have to check her wiki later. Don't really want to check a wiki, but I'm gonna... Okay, no. I don't think I... Yeah. Yeah, there was nothing here. I wasted my time. I'm sorry, I wasted everybody's time here. Swim. We'll fix our problems by swimming. Because... Yes. Thankfully, I don't have to walk on my way back now that I have the Sora Flippers. Don't need to go up there. I need to go this way. Yeah, pressing that A button. Getting stuck on walls. That's lovely. Thank you. Go, my Pegasus Boots. Let us fly. Don't need you in my way. Something exploded. Do I want to know what exploded behind me? Not really. I'll ignore it. Ow. Frickin' knocked a rock. Didn't need you to hit me from behind. I'm gonna go this way. Because time saving. Why not? Where else was I gonna go? There is a place near Sanctuary I want to go to, so we're going to go there first. Then we're going to head up to Death Mountain to get the last pendant. Two of which is right up around here. Going to go down here real quick. Now, if I remember correctly, this is Piece of Heart. Yep. We now have 7 hearts. Oh, wait, that's 8. I already had 7. We have 8 hearts now. We now have only 16 pieces of hearts to find. And we're only the 5th part into the Let's Play. That's nice. See, I can be proper and organized when it comes to my Let's Play, it's just that I'm not really too fond of it. There, you're dead. You have the bomb that I don't care for. I'll take pity on you since you're pooping out rupees. He exploded! I didn't know he exploded! He pooped out 3 rupees and then kaput! Oh no! That's awful. My god.
I don't know who you are, but if you're going up to that mountain, will you take me with you? I lost my lamp, so I can't see a gosh darn thing, sonny. If you can lead me through this cave, that'd be swell. But watch your step, young man, because the mountain's full of monsters. Many people have vanished in this mountain while looking for the golden power. No one steer you wrong, so please don't get involved in such a mad quest. If you do, sonny, do me a favor and cure my back problems. My back kind of hurts. You want to take a right here.
I have a granddaughter who's of your age. The king took her to the castle and she never returned. Kidnapping those maidens must be part of the wizard's plot.
I fear he somehow used the power of the descendants of the wise men.
I miss my granddaughter. I miss my family.
I'm all alone. I live up on a mountain all by my lonesome.
Because I'm old. And stupid. Why would I live up on a mountain? With falling rocks and evil things outside my front door. Why do I do this to myself? Why?
Missing maidens are still alive somewhere. I believe that a hero will rescue them. I wait for that day. Oh, these are dangerous times. I talked too much. I apologize, sonny. Thank you for your kindness to an old man like me. Wanted to give you this.
I got a mirror! That old man voice was annoying. Don't know why I did it, but I did it anyway. Old man, heal me. Thank you. Is there anything beyond here I need to look out for before I go up the mountaintops? I don't think so. I don't think there's anything in here I really need to look out for. Just slaughtered him. Okay, before I actually get lost and go back to where I came from, I'm gonna go back. It seems like the smart thing to do. Actually go to where we need to go for the dungeon. Take care of that, because we did some things that were necessary for this part. For the most of it. Well, that was from last to this part. We did some things that were side questy. Not even really side quests, but just the optional stuff that we really should get if we want to stay alive. I do plan to get the arrow and bomb expansion. The max amount of arrows you can have is 70 and bombs like 50. You need a crud ton of rupees for that, so I'm gonna wait till we actually have like max rupees again before we actually do that. That's just me. Like, if you don't want to wait for that, by all means don't, but it's recommended you do. Right here we have a portal. We want to keep this magic mirror open for us, but let's go back. Let's step in the portal. And we are a bunny. Who are you, Mr. Bunny? This world's like the real world, but evil has twisted it. The golden power is what changed your shape to reflect what is in your heart and mind. I'm always changing my mind, so I turn into a ball. But if a ball called the Moon Pearl, you can keep your original shape here. What do you want? Do you have something to say to me, you silly rabbit? I came here to get the golden power of the gold, but now I'm a freak and I can't go back to the real world. If only I had a Moon Pearl from the Tower of Hera, I could go back to my original shape. I've got good reason to be stressed out, so back off! Shoo shoo! So thankfully, since we have the magic mirror, we can leave the Dark World anytime we want. We'll get more into the Dark World later. But right now we have peace of heart. And we're probably going to go into the Tower of Hera now. To which we really should, considering the time frame what we're at this part. Which is 10 minutes, roughly. Might as well. I could end the session off after getting the Master Sword, so that works out. Now what I want to do... Okay, do I need... Okay, I need to think for a moment here. This dungeon I haven't really cared for. If only because of the boss. And just don't want to deal with that. Dungeon map! That's nice. Waiting for the fire to die out in front of me. All the Moldorms and these things. don't know what those are. They look like the dongos to me, but I don't think they are. Hit that. Go down. Now, you can complete this dungeon without getting the Moon Pearl, which is necessary to, beat the game. So, it's recommended you do get the Moon Pearl. If you want to, live. So, grab that, which is in this dungeon on, the third or fourth floor. I forget which one. But, oh boy, we got another one of those tile rooms. This is going to be one of something. Let me leave until it finishes, is it? Darn it. I don't want to fight the goddamn tiles. But I have to fight the tiles if I want to get into the next room. I'll be honest, I'm not a big fan of the tile concept. I mean, it's fine in the Oracle games because you can just swing like a madman, but here, no. I'm just not a fan in this game. It's just, that's annoying. Not even a heart to heal myself. That's irritating. That really is. And not a single one of them dropped a heart. I don't feel like wasting a fairy. Of course I would miss my target. There. Magic, alright. I could have used another heart, but I'll take 3 hearts. 3 hearts, after all, is better than 1 or 2, so I'll take that. Big key already. We're not even 3 minutes in the dungeon, we already got the big key. The first 3 dungeons are rather short. Then again, dungeons in general in the Link to the Past are pretty short. Link to the Past is just the better game of the series, and I kind of prefer it this way. I like the short dungeons. There's just more of them, I like that. Something I really think you need to revisit for the next Zelda game. Particularly one for the Wii U. Or they really should experiment with the whole, non-linearity for dungeons. Oh god, no, I am just gonna... Just gonna hit that. I'm out of here. Bye-bye. I am not dealing with that thing's bullshit. I refuse. I need to go up here. Now the third floor begins. Wait, it's the third floor? But we just went from the floor. Never mind. I'm not good with floors. I'm not good with anything. I don't want to hit the switch. Not in the slightest. Okay, I do want to hit the switch. Okay, well, not really. I don't really need to. There's no real reason to. You don't need to. It makes things easier, but you don't have to. Better. You, sir, need to get out of my face. Hit that. I think I need to... There we go. That's better. Jamie, is that you again? Probably messaging me from when I messaged you after I'm done recording a part. I probably should stop doing that. Right there is the magic mirror. I need to get that. Well, we need to get that. Without that, we can't complete the game, so it's kind of a thing. The one thing I always found weird is that this game you can actually complete it without getting a dungeon item, which confused the crud out of me. Well, for some of the dungeons, not all of them. You don't need to get the, Well, technically in Ice Rod, you do need to get the Flame Rod and Ice Rods. You need those. If only because of the boss of Dungeon 8. Oh, that boss Dungeon 8. I love that boss so much. You there. Die. And you, boom. I'm gonna just go up here real quick. I think there's actually a part up here where I can get to that part of the dungeon. Not what I meant to do. but better than me actually falling down to my death. So I'm gonna go up the stairs again. Probably really should finish this place up soon. I believe I want to go down this right here. If I'm correct, this is going to lead me to the... Yes, it is. Good. Moon Pearl! This protects the hero from change from the changing effects of the Golden Tower. And unlike Four Swords Adventures, which I did before this, Four Swords Adventures Moon Pearl allows you to enter the Dark World. This one just allows you to keep your original shape in it. So, that's nice. Now, I don't really want to bother fighting these things, but I don't have much of a choice here. Because the red one's a bit of a pain. And if I fall down against the boss, they're gonna be back. Well, boss time. I made note of him in my Four Swords Adventures LP, where we fought another Moldorm. This one's the bane of everybody's existence because of his stupid erratic patterns. Moldorm, boss of Tower of Hera, is a nightmare. If only because he has no real strategy to him. He doesn't really do much. And what really pisses people off, myself included, is that if he knocks you off the tower, or this part of the room, you have to redo the whole boss fight. Because his health will reset! Case in point! His health resets, the boss resets entirely. Which is annoying. I don't think they fixed that in the GBA port, and if they did, dear crap, why wouldn't they do that for the Virtual Console port? No! Moldorm! If I die again. If I fall off again, we're just gonna have a montage of me falling off, aren't we? Not a fan of you. Nobody who likes this game is a fan of you. Fuck you! Fudge you, Moldorm! Fudge you! You're dead, that's all that matters. Heart, mine. Pendant, mine. No. You won the Pendant of Wisdom! With this, you collected all three pendants. Go now to the Lost Woods to get the Master Sword! Fudge you, Moldorm! Fudge you! Okay! We're done for now. See you all next time on Let's Play The Legend of Zelda, A Link to the Past, where we'll head off to the Lost Woods and get the Master Sword, the Blade of Evil's Bane.